Adonai. We praise and glorify. Heaven and earth join to magnify. You are Adonai. Adonai, hallelujah. You are lifted high.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, it's not, I don't take this lightly. Listen, I don't mind preaching to 10 or 10,000, but can we just come just a little closer? Mm-hmm. Amen. So you can hear what God is saying. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God is good. And when you come closer, remain standing. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's just close our eyes and go in prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for today, oh God. For this is the day that you have made. For we will rejoice and be glad in it, oh God. Lord, I pray, oh God, first of all, I thank you for Pastor Corey, Father God. In the name of Jesus, thank you for the Crossroads family, oh God. Thank you, oh God, that you continue to bless them and incline them, oh God, more, oh God. Give them your spirit, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Father. Lord, we thank you, oh God, Lord, that you just begin to remove me out the way this morning, oh God. Oh God, that you speak through me, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. Lord, that it will be something said, oh God, that somebody, that they would not leave up this place, God, the same way, oh God. Lord, I pray for your spirit, oh God. I pray for your glory, oh God, to rain down on me, God, on today, God, like never before, God. In the name of Jesus, I give you all the glory. I give you all the honor, for you are worthy to be praised. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just continue to remain standing. First off, I give honor to God, who is the head of my life. I give honor to my apostle. I give honor to you and each and everybody here. Amen. Even to Facebook. Listen, if you would go with your Bible, I'm not going to take up too much of your time. Go with your Bible and turn with me to Acts chapter 27 and verse number 11. When you got it, say, I have it. Acts 27:11. Right. To you guys, don't give up in the storm.
Amen.
At the time of our text, we see it tells us that Paul was in a series of trouble. So much trouble that it placed his life in the lives of others around him in a mature danger. For we all told that there was no small ship could even catch up in the midst of the storm.
Yes.
You Bible readers, you all be aware the storm you see, he have already been arrested. And he was on his way to Rome to stand in trial. You may be seated. And now he's on the ship, caught up in the midst of a storm, of a life-threatening situation, a life-threatening storm, which was more troubled. And is that just like some of our lifetime stories? Before we could get one problem to rest, we always find ourselves in another situation.
Yeah.
You know, after one storm comes, it's another storm. We got this, you know, like life. You pay one bill and you think you caught up. You got another bill that's due.
Yes.
That's life. We find ourselves in a situation that we can never rest from. I can tell you from my own life experience that the problems of life sometimes come upon us before we can even get one thing caught up and strengthened out. There's another thing. There's another anchor that we face them. And no one can better testify to the fact that Job already may have been faced with series of problems that come one behind him and one another. He got over the trauma of the awesome impact of the first problem before he was hit with another problem. Uh-huh. And before he could really come to grasp with that, he had a third problem. Don't that seem like life? We get one problem. We got one problem taken care of. Then we got the second one. Uh-huh. And we finally got caught up with the second one. Yeah. But then there's always a third problem. Uh-huh. That's life coming. But listen, look at your neighbor and say, don't give up on the storm. Don't give up on that problem. Listen, the problem may come, but you let me tell you, you can just keep from being out of it. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, life is just like that old saying, when it rains, it pours. For that reason, Job said in Job 14:1, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. You got to understand the trouble may come, but it will not stay there very long. As it was with Job, so it was here in the test. In the text, we find Paul in a major trouble. If we can put a pin there, quickly, you got to end up. Let me tell you, just because you are a child of God, that don't mean you will not have troubles. Just because you are a child of God, it just means that when you have the trouble, you can get out of it. The question is, we must ask this morning, is not will the storm come, but how shall we respond when the storm comes? Should we complain? Should we talk about it? Or should we pray about it? And just in case there's someone looking at me right now, you can find yourself in the midst of a storm. I submit to you this morning, my brothers and my sisters, don't give up. Don't give up on the storm. These are the lessons that we can learn from in this episode, in the life of the Apostle Paul, that I believe can serve you as trouble, as that can you can get help when you encounter your own individual storms. First thing we can learn from is that they don't learn, that they don't last always. Look at your neighbor and say, the storm, it don't last always. I know it seems hard, but it don't last always. Now before they set sail from the island, Paul had already told the captain, I don't think you ought to make this trip at least now, but I hope you will wait a little while longer. I know the itinerary says, I know that there are prisoners in addition to myself that you had to deliver to various places. For Paul said, I perceive that it would be life threatening if you set sail right now. But the captain, disregards Paul, had to say, he disregarded, calm down real quick, I'll let you know when to go. He disregarded, don't look around now, but there are so many of our days and times that are ignored. Things that the preacher had to say, there are things who there are people who sit frequently in the pews, in the seats, Sunday after Sunday, listening to the things, listening to a thing that not listening, I'm sorry, not listening to a thing the interesting that continue to get it and find themselves in trouble. There's people sitting in the pews Sunday after Sunday. Don't listen, but find themselves with a generation where they find themselves sitting there on Facebook, sitting there on Instagram. Many people make true of the word of the OJ song. Some of y'all seasoned folks know what I'm talking about. That says your body here with me, but your mind is on the other side of town. You don't know that some people are at church, but they are not really at church. What are you talking about? They're not really there. Their body is there, but their spirit is gone. My brothers and sisters, there is a danger in missing the message. So often, my brothers and sisters, the warning is giving, but because we are not listening, we find ourselves in stormy situations. I can go on behind the preacher and say there are some problems. There are some people in here right now who wish they had listened to their mother and father, or even their grandfather or their grandmother, when they said don't do something. Not only did they miss the message that they should have listened to, but they found themselves all over it. But you gotta understand, I dare somebody to take a praise break and say, I'm listening now. I dare you to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, are you listening to the preacher? But I can't really criticize the captain too much if I am too, and I am to be totally honest. There have been times in my life when I had to depart too soon. Or now, what continue to latch out too soon, where I can break it down. As simple as this, you are latching out too soon. How many of y'all feel like that? I remember when I first pastored, I had people that said, you latched out too soon. You should have started prayer. You latched out too soon. And now, I wish now I can take back and listen what they said. Because sometimes you may feel ready, but you may be knowing that it's too soon. It's too soon to walk in the storm. It's too soon because you may not understand how to get yourself out of the flood. Because when it rains, there's always a flood. We on the bottom. This is known as a flooding sign. When it rains, but you understand, when it rains, I need you now. When it rains, and sometimes we find ourselves in the flood of life, when we can't get ourselves out of that situation. You understand it? When you jump into something without God's endorsement, without God's direction, and without God's blessing, that moving is too soon. That move is too soon. Listen, you moving, I know it seems like you want to move, but it's too soon. I know it seems like that you want that new job, but God said, be faithful at this one. It's too soon. If you move now, you're going to miss out. If you move now, you will drown in the storm. Be careful. Make for sure that you got the endorsement. Make for sure you got the blessing. mercy. Oh God, before he say it's too soon, it's too soon. If that sometimes what we want to do, God does it for us. Sometimes when we want to move, when we want something, oh, we feel God, I want this, and we feel like that if we go get it, it's gonna be all right. But sometimes God make a rich situation where you get it for us. God know how to do things, although sometimes God tells us it's too soon. If he feel like you're ready, he gives it to you. We know ourselves for that reason. He does know where our spiritual level is, where it needs to be. He knows if we haven't matured in Christ, we are not ready to launch out right now. Sometimes God knows the level of our maturity, and sometimes it's just that he would not allow us to walk in purpose if he know we will blow it, if he know we're not mature enough to handle it. But because they refuse to listen, they launched out too soon, and shortly after they launching, they fell into the midst of a rainy storm. That sound like us. Sometimes they tell us we make it mad at the preacher, you because we feel like we ready to launch the ministry. We make it mad at our bishop or apostle, because he said, I'm not supporting, because I know you're not ready. But let me tell you the reason why you can't get mad at the preacher. Don't get mad at your apostle. Don't get mad at your bishop. Sometimes he knows that if you walk now, you're going to miss out all that blessing. If you're large, yes, you may tell yourself, I'm so ready. I'm ready to do this. But the minute you're large, you find yourself in a storm. I'm not talking about you. Let me talk about me. Back in 2000, Lord, I feel you. Back in 2014, when God said, start, he gave me destiny, empowerment center. I was so ready. I had the idea. I had the beauty. I can pack it out. But then I found myself at the beginning where I felt myself crashing. Because God said, I heard God clearly. He said, prayer services. But I wanted to not listen. And I wanted to pastor on Sunday. And I found myself the launch crashing. I found myself in the middle of a storm where I found myself drowning in the middle of that storm. You got to understand what God said. The day is not denial. I was on a prayer call on yesterday. I ministered on it. And I heard the pastor. I heard her say, delay, delay is not denial. I came to prophesy right here. Delay is not denial. I know God gave you that vision, but don't launch yet, because you're gonna, don't give up in the storm, because the storm is your warning. Don't get mad if your pastor say, I'm not gonna ordain you right now. You're not ready, but you continue to serve and watch it go, because he knows what's best for you. He knows if you're gonna fall in the storm. The storm is identified in verse 14 of King James. It said it was called the Echo. Now that storm was an awful storm. That storm was the granddaddy of all storms. It was a wind of great that came out the northeast. Oh my God, I feel my help now. Should I preach or should I quit? It came like 10,000 wolves. The sound of E was like fire, and it would be terrible thing to wait. It would anger the wind, the sea. It would cause the sea to become rough. But listen, that in the ship that was caught in this storm, it found itself being kicked like football from one wave to another. And let me tell you, sometimes we can't move without, we can't move without the wind. But if the wind comes, y'all know about a tornado. Sometimes the wind, we need the wind. But if you get a rough wind, that's when the storm comes. Sometimes we need the wind, but other times the wind produces a storm. And we gotta make for sure that we are guarding in that storm. We gotta make for sure that we can move in spite of the storm that we in, in spite of the situation that we are facing right now. I came to prophesy to someone right now. That storm is not coming to make you drown, but it's coming to give you life. That storm that's in your house is coming to give you life. I know it seems a little hard. I know it seems a little rough, but that storm is coming to set you free. It's coming to do what God promised. There's a storm all over you, but listen, how you know that it's a good storm and it was ordained by God? Because after the storm comes a rainbow. I see the rainbow over your head. That's how you know that it was endorsed by God, because it produced a rainbow. It produced God's promise. It produced grace. It produced mercy. It produced favor. It produced love. It produced. It produced ministry. It produced a lot. Listen, I gotta give you something for free. I just got this right now. Listen, I know you seem like that the promise never coming, but I came to declare a word to you that God's promise is over your life. God told me to tell you. He said, this is only for three of them. He said, my storm is coming to make you know that I'm visible in your life. I know it seems like I'm not there, but I came to let you know that I'm visible and I'm doing a new thing in your life. I know it seems a little rough, but trust me, the storm is coming. And after the storm, as long as you listen and take note, the storm is not going to produce a flood, but the storm is going to produce my favor. The storm is going to produce my endorsement. The flood, the storm is going to produce my grace, my grace, my grace, my grace.
that situation get you out of that storm. I know it seems rough. I know it seems like it's hard, but you came to get out of that storm. God is going to get you out of that storm. Hallelujah. He said he will get you out of that situation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because we sit there constantly not understanding what life is throwing at you. Sometimes we have no ideas the storm of life that we face. Hallelujah. It could be a storm of good, but the storms to get in your home, hallelujah, it caused travail with your family. The storms, it gets you. If you give up the storms in churches, you have an article with a brother and sister in the church, hallelujah, just to see how you're going to deal with it. Will you let the storm come and allow the rainbow to shine afterwards? Or will you let the storm come and allow the flood to come and get drowned? Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I'd rather after the storm, I don't want to lose myself in the storm. I don't want to give up in the storm, but I don't want to flood. But after the storm, hallelujah, I want the rainbow to shine over me, saying, listen, you held on. You done what I promised you. The storm, listen, a bad storm can affect your health. A bad storm, it can affect your health. It can affect your mind. It can even affect your family. Hallelujah. Don't give up in the storm. Hallelujah. Don't give up in that storm. Hallelujah. The storm comes in our lives. All of us. Ain't no one exempt from that storm. It's up to you how you gonna deal with it. I don't know about y'all, but I don't know how to swim. So listen, if I handle that storm wrong and the flood come, I'm just gonna drown and I'm giving up. But listen, because I'm mature enough in God, when the storm come, what is the storm, Prophet Josh? Listen, that storm is financial hardship, family problems. Listen, I came earlier and I heard Prophetess Ebony talking about the storm of a marriage. Listen, if your husband or your wife cheated on you, and you seen the person, and you want to get evil, listen, you know your storm, the flood, but you got to say, I'm going to love you in spite of, I'm going to love you. I know sometimes you feel people don't give you no good. Listen, sometimes it can be the storm on a job, but listen, look at the situation and say, I don't want the flood to take me out, but I'm handling this situation. I will love you because I want the storm to shine on me. After the storm, I want the rainbow. After the storm, I want the love. After the storm, I want God to get me out of this situation. And say, listen, you are able to do what I promised you. To tell you I don't know you, but God told me to tell you there's the storm of your finances that you battle with. I hear you, Holy Ghost. There's the storm of your finances that you battle with, but God told me to tell you he's taking you through this storm to see how you gonna handle, how you gonna hear my voice. He said after the storm there's gonna be multiple streams of income to hit your hands like never before. He told me, he said, tell her the storm is almost over. He said, tell her she won't drown, but he said, tell her I'm getting her through this situation. He said, sometimes he puts you through the storm to see if he can trust you. He said, there's people that's been dependent on you for finances, and he said that you will give it to him. But God said in this season, if he give it to you, he will tell you who they give it to. But you gotta be selfish in this season. You don't want the storm to come and not make it out. You get drowned in the flood. I feel you, Holy Ghost. I hear you, Jesus. Listen, God told me to tell you. Listen right now. I hear you, Holy Ghost. I hear you, Holy Ghost. I hear you, Holy Ghost. I need some worshipers. I need some worshipers. Hallelujah. I need worshipers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God said, sometimes you gotta be low when to let go. Right now, you're in the storm, and it seems like you're not getting out of that storm. I don't know you, but God said the reason why the storm feel like it's throwing you some heavy winds is because God told you no, but you keep being disobedient. God said let go, you said no. God said he told you to let it go, but you keep trying to force it. God told me to tell you that you gotta let it go. If you don't let it go, if you don't let it go, that wind will come and the storm will get heavy and you will drown. I don't know what that means, but I'm sure you do. Let it go. Don't get drowned in the flood. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. I need some worshipers. I need some worshipers. Lord God, we want to know how to make it after the storm. We want to know how to survive after the storm. We don't want to give up in the storm, but we want to stay focused on your word, because your word is real. Your word is glory. Well, now I came to prophesy while I'm preaching. God said, will you pass the storm, the test, and survive the storm, survive the problem? Listen, you don't want to be like Paul. Paul had problems after problems after trouble after trouble. He got arrested. And listen, you don't want to be in that situation. You don't want to be, listen, you want to survive that storm. Hallelujah. God said, he told me, he said, when you get the crossroads, to let them know that they will survive past the quarry. This is for crossroads. God said, because you was in the storm. I don't know what this means to you, but he said you was in the storm for 3 years. He said there was people that came to this ministry that was not ordained by me. He said there was people that came in this ministry that I did not endorse. And because you allowed them to roam freely, he said the storm came. But listen, you almost got drowned in the storm. But listen, in the flood, I don't know what this means. There was people came to your ministry that had the wrong agendas. They tried to take the ministry from you. They secretly talked about you and said he don't know what he doing. I can take the ministry, and you almost drowned in the storm. You almost got drowned in the flood. And let me tell you, as I be a prophet of God, they almost took this very ministry from you. You would have been lost out in the cold, not knowing what you're going to do. But thank God, you survived the storm. You survived the rainbow. I can't help it but see a little glimpse of the rainbow. Why the little and not the full? Because God told me to tell you, you still in the storm. You may survive it a little bit, but you still in it. He said, listen, he called you to this place. This is your ministry. This is your church. He gave it to you. He said, seek me. I hear you, Holy Ghost. God told me to tell you to seek him before anyone with any agenda. Say, I want to be your associate. I want to be your pastor. I need to help you. God says, seek me first and let me know if I endorse them. If they got the blessing, you got to be careful for people that come to that, because they will take your ministry. And listen, I don't know what this means. They tried. They almost had it. They almost had it. I don't know. I'm right here. They almost had it. But God told me to tell you, it did not work, because he gave you the approval. He gave you the endorsement for this place. Hallelujah. And he said, listen, that's why you rebuilding. Because they tried to take it. And because it did not work, they told lies on you. Hallelujah. They told lies on you. Hallelujah. Listen, I hear the lies, not physically, but I hear the lies in the spirit. I hear them talking now. Hallelujah. It's that little fly on the wall sometimes, and you just hear people talking about you because you're that little fly. I hear those flies with my spiritual ears. Listen, they try to break you down. Hallelujah. God said, listen, he got you. You still in the storm, but there's a little rainbow. But there's a way to make it big by seeking God and all that you do. Let's stand up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. For you are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. I give you all the glory, Jesus. I give you all the honor. For you are worthy to be praised, God. Hallelujah. I got to do one thing.
Grace and peace. I am Prophet Joshua Williams. I'm super excited what God is doing in your life. Listen, I need for you to join me every Friday at 9:30 for the prophetic prayer call. There's power in prayer. there's strength in numbers. Do you want to be the change that we want to see in our community, in our governments, on our jobs, and in our family? Connect live with me every Friday night at 9:30 for the prophetic prayer. Listen, if you got love Jesus, but you don't want to step in church, listen, you do it from the comfort of your own home, from your smartphone or computer and tablet. Listen, just join me. Call that number on your screen. Tell them that you want to be a virtual member. Listen, we'll get you all the information you need. We help to get you on Sunday. They get you weekly service for Bible studies and Sunday services. Listen, live worship with us. You don't want to miss it. Listen, we're taking this thing to a whole nother level. Listen, as a millennium and in the 21st century, listen, we're doing what God commanded. Listen, I'm a 21st century called to reconcile, deliver, and raise up people to be used by God for such a time as this. You don't want to miss what God is doing. Listen. Follow me on Instagram and follow me on Instagram and Facebook to see what goes on in my word. Listen, come.
What an amazing God we serve. Hi, I'm Prophet Joshua Williams. I'm asking you to join me every Friday at 9:30 for the prophetic prayer call for 30 minutes. There's power in prayer. There's strength in numbers. Let us be the change that we want to see in our communities, within our families, within our businesses, on our jobs, in our churches. For 30 minutes, let's connect together on a prophetic prayer call at 9:30.
Join Prophet Joshua Williams every Friday for prophetic prayers. Call 605-313-6093 with access number 196-461 at 9:30 for 30 minutes of prayer without ceasing. Become a virtual member today and let Prophet Joshua be your pastor.